Welcome to this episode of In Conversation. I'm Ravindran Subramanian from the Corporate Communication Team of HDFC Bank. We have with us Mr. Rahul Shukla, who is a group head. Rahul straddles two diverse businesses in the bank. One is corporate banking, the other is business banking. Both of them, as Rahul would readily agree, call for two entirely different approaches. Rahul is also a relatively new entrant to the HDFC Bank family, having joined us after a long stint with another bank. Welcome, Rahul.
And good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
First things first, Rahul, you straddle two different portfolios, like we said in the introduction. One is corporate banking, the other is business banking. What's your vision for both the businesses?
Well, Ravi, thanks for asking me, that question. At the end of the day, if you begin your journey, as a small corporate from business banking, the end goal, is where you end up is in corporate banking, because every company aspires to become big and aspires to become large, and they end up in, corporate banking, right? So in that sense, this is not very diverse. It is just, picking up two ends of, the continuum and putting, that under, the same person. And it is my privilege to go out and run the two businesses. The approach to the two businesses are slightly different. In corporate banking, my goal is pretty simple. I want to make HDFC Bank's corporate bank the best corporate bank as recognized by corporates in the country. And that is, where we are going to basically take it. We do have asset capacity. We do have a lot of transaction banking business. But I want to add up even more cross-sell at the end of the day with each of our top corporates. We have many diverse goals that we are working on. One of the metrics that I always look at, the success of corporate banking is the ratio of non-lending revenues divided by the lending revenues, to understand whether we are getting everything else that is going away to banks who do not put out credit at all. So that is, the first bit. The second thing that I look at is portfolio concentration. That if 80% of your credit is concentrated over X number of clients, can we go out and make it more diversified? And so therefore, we have a next 100 initiative where we are pushing, deeper into, the credit segment across our client base, so that we continue to reduce concentration risk, across. And I'm a big believer that we have to go out and be the trusted advisor, for our clients, that when they think of, something, whether it is a issue with, their salary account with us at a personal level, or a very big, issue around succession planning, trust account, a big, merger and acquisition target, the first phone call that they make is to my relationship manager in the corporate bank. And that's the way I see a corporate bank, and that is what I would strive to, build it into. SME is a completely different ball game. In this country, at this point of time, there are 1.15 crore corporate registrations in the GST system. Out of that, 1.07 crore is about MSME. I don't have a precise figure, would be my target market, on which there is a huge amount of data that is available. And SMEs are coming up in every district. So we have to manage a diverse platform. It is just on the cusp of retail moving into corporate, and we have to manage a footprint that straddles across the countryside. So I have to count that, look, we are operating in 450 districts or so for our clients, but in the country there are 700 districts. So how do I, move forward into each, district and penetrate deeper and deeper, because the heart and soul of this country lies in the success and entrepreneurship of the SME segment.
Would I be right in presuming, Rahul, in terms of your vision for the business, the idea is that since corporate bank is already well established, the idea is to enhance the leadership or consolidate the leadership position further and emerge as a preferred advisor. Whereas in SME, while there is a certain position that HDFC Bank enjoys, the idea would again be to then, in this case, would be to build it up and take it to a leadership position.
I couldn't have put it better myself. So thank you, you know, for putting words to, you know, what I was trying to communicate. You're absolutely right. In the SME segment, there again, you know, we might lead with credit, but there is a huge amount of, you know, cross-sell that is available. And the lines between the entrepreneur and his corporate are quite blurred. And so therefore, we have to go out and capture, you know, the entire thing around it. And in many cases, you know, all these entrepreneurs are part of a community, and so things, you know, happen with referral. So if you go, you know, from Jammu to Northeast to, you know, down south and the extreme ends of, you know, Gujarat, we have millions of these entrepreneurs, and this is, you know, what we need to go out and tap and then, you know, help them grow and move them along the line to a mid-market, you know, size corporate and ultimately to a corporate banking, you know, side. Sized corporate.
So partnering with them in the journey, so that would be the mantra where business banking is concerned. Or partnering with them as a transition, so maybe say from a business banking to mid-market and then finally to corporate banking. Would that be correct?
Absolutely. What is you know, a bank's role? Everybody, you know, when they talk to you about being a banker, you can see that, you know, they think that bankers make a lot of money, but that is not, you know, what banking is all about. Banking is, you know, not a manufacturing company because we do not, you know, go out and manufacture a product. It is a financial services industry and the entire mindset is around services. So if you think about, you know, what the banks do, they push out, you know, credit into the economy, and on the retail side, it then helps, you know, uplift a lot of people, you know, outside of poverty into, you know, giving them better lives. And that is what we do also with, you know, the smaller companies, as these, you know, people who are coming out of poverty and, you know, moving into mom and pop shops and then becoming an SME, traveling with them in the journey where they, from being, you know, basically a job seeker, continue to become large corporates and provide, you know, jobs to many people.
Fantastic, Rahul, but then there would be one challenge when you're say dealing with, say, the business banking, the SME and the MSME space. While for corporate banking, credit data would be easily available, or let me put it this way, credit history would be easily available. That might not be the case in the case of the business banking segment. How do you then ensure credit quality?
So you think about it like this, you know, the first banking 101 for anybody in corporate banking or wholesale banking is KYC, which is, you know your customer. And I think in the past, you know, we used to talk to, you know, relatives, other business people, and, you know, go out and get reference checks, which we still have to do because we've got to know, you know, basically the promoter or the driver behind an organization. But today, there are two reforms that have happened in this country which are game-changing. Whether they are perceived as such or not, but for banking, these are, you know, just absolutely game-changing. One is demonetization, which essentially made sure that more and more economy became formalized and more transactions started happening, you know, through the banking system. And the second is, you know, GST, where there is a monthly filing, and so on a monthly basis you have a pretty good idea of how the business is doing. Now I'm not talking about, you know, credit extension where you're putting out 50 crore or 100 crore, but at a granular level there is sufficient amount of data that is available today in our economy, which again, you know, makes me believe that that in the next 10 years the generational effect of these reforms that are going to happen in the country, we can't even fathom today as to, you know, what it is going to be like, because the data availability is what everyone around the world, you know, struggles with, whether it is the developed world or, you know, the developing world, and that is one thing that we don't have a challenge with.
Digitalization or digitization is the name of the game. What is the role you see this play in corporate banking as well as in business banking?
So one can step back and say that, look, in corporate banking, you know, things are maybe a little bit staid, and, you know, digitization, you know, may not have a role, right? But you think about it in two things, right? A corporate does a lot of transactions, whether it is domestic trade or international trade, exports or imports, you know, bills discounting, and so on and so forth. So a lot of these transactions can be done completely paperless, and the bank has a leadership in paperless imports. It is moving into paperless exports, and we have a trade on net, you know, platform which is completely paperless and helps, you know, corporates get into that journey. And in terms of, you know, doc warehousing, we also, you know, pick up documents, you know, for clients and do take away, you know, the grunt work, you know, from the corporate to ourselves. So that is, you know, effectively the role of the bank. But after having done that, the second, you know, thing that we provide is MIS. And that is the number one requirement of, you know, corporates. Today, corporates may not also have an idea of where their money is going, but we will know through our analytics as to where money is going. And that is a very, very important, you know, thing that we go out and provide, where we have leadership, and that is what translates into leadership in the economy on transaction banking completely. And the last bit is, you know, if you look at everything related to control and compliance, frauds, AML, all those issues, I think, you know, digitization basically becomes the name of the game, because there are millions of transactions. You can't even fathom, you know, the size of the of the bank and the number of transactions that we process. If you do not, you know, deploy digitization, then you would lose the plot. And at this point of time, we feel very comfortable. Internally, we always feel, you know, we are still not, you know, where we would like to be. And that is the impatience of, you know, this organization, which spurs us, you know, forward, and which is what, you know, brings us into the workplace with a lot of sense of joy and happiness, because you're going to accomplish something new in the organization every single day.
Okay. You spoke something very interesting right now, or you said something very interesting right now, that is MIS, providing MIS to customers who probably don't even have it, right? Would you say that this is going to be differentiated going forward, or is this just one more value addition we provide to the customer?
Actually, MIS is, you know, in a way, soul of the organization. Look at, you know, how we deploy MIS, right? And how we track everything. That is the power of MIS. It's like, you know, the iPod. Until it came out, you didn't even know that you needed an iPod. And until, you know, MIS is thrown at your face, you may not even realize that you actually needed it. Yes, there is a difference between data dump and MIS. And our bank excels in giving MIS versus, you know, dumping data on your clients.
Any personal insight that has, say, shaped your career?
I think,
or some advice that you perhaps received?
No, I'll tell you a few things, right? You know, I mean, number one is the need for constant learning, because in banking you have to learn continuously. Otherwise, very soon you will realize that you are dated, and just as you don't buy a dated product in the supermarket, you will not be fit for an organization. So that is, you know, very important as number one. The second is, you know, mobility. Because I was mobile, I have always, you know, benefited in my career as a result of that. And when you see, you know, different regions, different countries, different cultures, that shapes you as a person completely. And the third thing that I would say is that you always have to seek out mentors, ask questions. And that mentor could be a senior, that could be a peer, that could be a junior. But you have to ask questions when you don't understand and when you want to, you know, bounce off your ideas. And you should never be ashamed or, you know, basically shy of doing that. And I do it, you know, basically on and off all the time. And those are three things that I do. I want to give one advice to the people, that in an organization, while we have 85,000 people, it's not about 85,000 people. It is about, you know, the 30 people who surround you and that you work with. And if you enjoy that companionship and camaraderie, right, you're always going to be there no matter what, because these are people, you know, who are your friends and you spend time. And that's why I always, you know, tell my team members that make the working environment of the people in the teams around them, you know, pleasureful, that when you walk into the morning, walk into the office in the morning, you actually are thrilled about, you know, coming to work rather than it being a drag, whether it is a Monday or a Sunday.
One last word, Rahul.
I always tell my team, your work ethic is your personal brand. You work hard not for X, Y, or Z. You work hard for who you are as an individual, and never lose sight of that. And never let, you know, despondency, you know, come in the way. Work is joy. It is a great joy, you know, when we are at HDFC Bank, because it is such an open culture. Thank you.
Thanks, Rahul. Thank you very much for your time.